You learn more from failure than from success. So don't let it stop you. Failure builds character. Hi guys, most welcome on my channel Indissues. And today in this video, we will cover the current affairs of 12th January. So if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, then please like, subscribe and share it. Now friends, let me tell you, we also provide Hindi current affairs video. And if you want to PDF of these questions, then you can visit on my Telegram group Indissues, and links are also given in the description box. Now friends, please watch the video till end, because at the end of the video, you will get some new important GK bonus facts. Now friends, let's begin. And friends, question number first is, when is National Youth Day celebrated? Right answer is 12th January. So friends, 12th January is celebrated as National Youth Day. Now friends, if we talk about a National Youth Day, so 1984 AD was declared as the International Youth Year, as declared by the United Nations. And friends, the government of India announced that from 1984 to 12th January, the day of Swami Vivekananda Jayanti should be celebrated all over the country as National Youth Day. And friends, next one is, who was elected the General Secretary of All India Ear Maheshwari Samaj Women's Organization? So right answer is Manju Bangar. So friends, Manju Bangar elected the General Secretary of All India Ear Maheshwari Samaj Women's Organization. And now friends, if we talk about this, so the election was held at a meeting and function of the Women's Bodies Exclusive Board held at Somnath. And friends, the organization's president Asa Maheshwari was elected. And friends, here is the next one. Who was nominated for the World Games Athlete of the Year Award? Right answer is Rani Rampal. So friends, the International Hockey Federation FIH, the governing body of world hockey, has nominated Rani Rampal for the World Games Athlete of the Year Award. And friends, currently Rani Rampal is the captain of Indian women's hockey team. And friends, this winner will be decided by online voting, which ends on January 30. Okay friends, so now move on to the next one. Which historian, researcher and writer passed away recently? Right answer is M. Chidanmurthy. So friends, historian, researcher and writer M. Chidanmurthy died on Bangalore. And friends, he was also known for his campaign for the preservation of Hampi monuments. And M. Chidanmurthy was born on 10th May 1931. Now friends, next question is, when did the Trust and Cyber Reassurance Project launch? So right answer is 11th January 2020. So friends, the Union Minister Amit Shah on Saturday digitally launched Vishwas and Cyber Aashwast at Mahatma Mandir in Gandhinagar. And friends, Vishwas is an acronym for video integration and state-wide advanced security. And friends, Vishwas is a major e-governance initiative. The project aims to improve law and order management, proactive traffic management and control, crime detection and post-investigation, and video forensic through video analytics. Alright friends, so let's move on to the next one. Who will inaugurate the integrated steel hub? And its right answer is Dharmendra Pradhan. So friends, the Union Steel Minister Dharmendra Pradhan is set to inaugurate an integrated steel hub to surround Odisha, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, West Bengal and North Andhra Pradesh on Saturday. And friends, this steel hub aims to invest about $70 billion in the steel sector and promote economic development in eastern India. Okay friends, so now move on to the next one. In which state was the Hampi festival organized? So its right answer is Karnataka. So friends, the Hampi festival organized in Karnataka. Now friends, if we point out about Hampi festival, so friends, the Hampi festival, also known as the Vijay Utsav, is the largest celebration of the ancient Vijayanagara Empire so far. And friends, this festival takes place every year in Virupaksha temple, which commemorates the culture and tradition of bygone era. Now friends, here if we talk about Karnataka, so its capital is Bengaluru. Currently its chief minister is B.S. Yediyurappa, while governor is Vazubhai Wala. Okay friends, so here is the next one. Who inaugurated the Indian Cyber Crime Coordination Center? So its right answer is Amit Shah. So friends, Amit Shah inaugurated the Indian Cyber Crime Coordination Center. Now friends, things to know about this Cyber Crime Coordination Center. So the Indian Cyber Crime Coordination Center was approved by the central government in October 2018, and friends, this center will address all kinds of cyber crimes related issues in the country. Now friends, so far 15 states UTs have agreed to set up regional cyber crime coordination centers in their states. All right friends, so now move on to the next one. Who was sworn in as the new Sultan of Oman? So friends, its right answer is Hashim bin Tariq Al Said. So friends, Hashim bin Tariq Al Said was sworn in as the new Sultan of Oman. And friends, here the important points are: Sultan of Oman Qaboos bin Al Said has died at the age of 79 years. So that's why Hashim bin Tariq Al Said, Oman's culture minister and cousin of late Sultan Qaboos, has been sworn in as the country's new Shah. Now friends, if we talk about Oman, so its capital is Muscat. Currently its prime minister and sultan is Hashim bin Tariq Al Said, while the currency of Oman is Omani Riyal. Alright friends, so now move on to the last question of today. Question is CAA 2019, since when did it become the complete law? So friends, its right answer is 10th January 2020. Alright friends, so the important points are: the Citizenship Amendment Act CAA 2019 was passed by the Parliament of India on 11th December 2019. And friends, this act amended the Citizenship Act in 1955, providing a path for Indian citizenship to Hindu, Sikh, Buddhist, Jain, Parsi and Christian religious minorities. And friends, it was introduced by Amit Shah, who is currently serving as UN Minister of Home Affairs. Now friends, let's discuss the yesterday's question, which was asked in the previous video. The question was that, where will India's first transgender university open? So friends, its right answer is Uttar Pradesh. So friends, India's first transgender university will be open in Uttar Pradesh. Now friends, here is the today's question, which you have to answer in the comment section. And now you can answer me on my Telegram group as well. And here is the question. In January 2020, the famous Rath Utsav of Suchindram Thanumalayan Temple was celebrated in which state? A option is Kerala, B option is Karnataka, option C is Tamil Nadu, while option D is Madhya Pradesh. So friend, please answer this question in the comment section. Now friends, that's all for today, and we will be back with the next video. Till then, you take care. And now, if you are visiting first time, then please like, subscribe and share this channel more. Now friends, let's enjoy the today's bonus facts.